60 years ago, BASF started a production site in the port of Antwerp. In the meantime, it has grown to the second largest in the world.
The BASF grids are all over the site. Sometimes they are far away, sometimes they are underground. It's a big challenge to keep this network stable and operating in a flexible way.
One of the most challenging grids is the brackish water grid. It is used here as cooling water. As it is brackish water, biocides kill biology that grows in it. These biocides may not go back to the environment, and we must also be sure that when we dose it, it reaches all pipes.
By using Simcenter, we are able to avoid having biological growth in our brackish water network.
In my job, we focus on long-term changes. Since our grid is quite complex, we made a digital twin, and that helps us detecting changing flows, changing temperatures to provide, for example, water hammering in our steam grid.
An executable digital twin has a simulation or a test-based model at its core. It contains a physics-based behavioral model connected to a physical system in order to make calculations for flows, for pressures, for temperatures. And with these calculations, we can predict how changes would be. We can also analyze the current situation, and we can accordingly optimize operations itself.
Real-time monitoring is really important to have transparency on the grid. We can implement scenarios in the model, so we can stay ahead of the problem.
The operators are able to see how the flows are running and in which direction and how the system works in real time. To have a realistic view on the grid, we need to have the day-to-day data.
These real data are available at the entry of each plant as billing data. So in order to use these data, we addressed a third party, ORIZE, to do the integration of the Simcenter software with the BASF systems itself.
Every 15 minutes, they make a bunch of data and import it to the Simcenter data, and then we have the output of our grid.
For the automation, we didn't need to install any flow meters or pressure transmitters or other sensors, and the operators could quickly pick up the functionalities of Simcenter. As we have positive results, we'd like to extend the digital twin to other pressurized grids.